Hewish Park, the home of the Glovers. Achieving by unity. All from the highs.
I believe that the age of disparity, disarray, low morale is over. We now embark on a progressive and ambitious future for Yeovil Town.
To the lows.
Fuck! Fuck's sake!
You should come and catch the last one. You're the fucking goalie. Come and catch it. Just come and catch the fucking ball.
A Yeovil Town documentary. Yeovil Town, Do or Die, Part 2. The players are set and ready for training, and they know what they need to do in the last 8 games to stay up in the National League. The lads have been told strict instructions from Mark Cooper when applying themselves in games, and what they really need to do to hold themselves afloat in the National League. Now, it's showtime. The last 8 games are vital to staying up, and Yeovil know exactly what's at stake. Yeovil Town hosts South Bend United, who have travelled down to Hewish Park for a Saturday afternoon kickoff. Will Buse and Grant Smith are out for their warm-up, with Loney Will Buse still yet to make an appearance this season for the Glovers, but he's looking for his first in the last few games for Yeovil. Pressure and tension is high around the club as the stewardship owners, staff and players are all finding it difficult to come to terms with other distractions and changes around Hewish Park. Mark Cooper provides a video for the Glovers to watch before going out to kickoff. It's the history of the club. Do the Glovers want to see another relegation?
Seven years ago, boys, this club playing, well, whatever it was, 7, 8 years ago, playing the championship. Dan Byrne, fucking Marcus Stewart, right players they've had here. Have to have some pride. It's got to start now.
Got 8 games.
I don't care about the result. I don't care about the fucking result. We need a performance from everybody. We need a fucking performance. We can't have what we had last Saturday, first 10 minutes. And I don't blame you for that. I don't blame you for that. But whatever goes on, up there, wherever, we can't control that. You can't control, I can't control it. All we can control is here and out the pitch. We have to find something. Today, Tuesday, Friday, Monday, we have to find something. Whatever it takes, boys. And I'm going to do my best to help you on the side. I'm going to try and help you as much as I can. When we get tired, I'm going to try and make the right sub. You got to go. You got to fucking go. That doesn't mean somebody goes and 2-foot somebody and we're down 10 minutes. Set your fucking stall out. First 10 minutes. See what the game brings. Don't let them get in their stride. Think about what I spoke to you yesterday about the pitch. Got some good players in it. Some good characters. Some good fucking players. If I look around, it's easy to talk. We've got a shout out there.
The game is set and ready to go. The lads, the fans, the staff. No, this is an important game. Kickoff at Huish Park. Scott Pollock with an early opportunity which is saved by the goalkeeper, but a great start from the Glovers. Goal for Southend. They go one up after Jake Hyde was found open in the box and slots the ball into the bottom right. Yeovil are losing again, but they know they can't give in. Mark Cooper encourages the boys, and so does the skipper. Cross comes in and the header is met by Scott Pollock, which glances off the post. Freckleton rightly isn't happy with the half.
Fucking shit set piece in my cool game. One fucking throw in, whatever it was, man. And the fucking goal.
You've done really well. I'm going to take you off now. Protect you. Okay? So Fish is going to come on. Up front. With Yummy. Jordan Wydrew is going in behind. Scotty Pollock going next to Dukes. See how you go. You alright?
Yeah.
Has anybody got anything to say to Fish?
Yeah, fucking come on and make a difference.
Fucking be the man. Play like you look nice team, look nice. They just sat there thinking these will fucking give us a goal in a minute. Soft as shit. Rosie, I need a bit 10% more from your kid. Okay? So we've got two forwards. What can we afford to do? Yeah, we can play off them a little bit. You know, we can come around the front, or Geordie comes around the front, we're playing behind, tickle the ball down the side of him. Fucking delighted we're attacking at half now.
Yeah.
Crosses, shots. Crosses, shots, back it up. There's going to be some moments where you're going to have to defend that fucking goal. Hey, talk's cheap. People need to stand up. Come on, go all right.
Come on,
nothing in the game.
Come on,
nothing in the fucking game.
Hey, leave nothing in it. Whatever we fucking do,
Come on, come on.
Hey, stand up. Be the fucking difference. Come on, don't fucking come in here. Ask him what ifs. No what ifs today. Fucking come on.
Back out for the second half, and Alex Fisher comes on the field half-time. Only just a few minutes after half-time, Alex Fisher goes down injured. It's a truly bad injury.
As soon as it happened, it took a few seconds for me to process. I'd say a good 10, 15 seconds to process just the way it felt. I didn't have an instant rush of pain. And when I went to feel what I thought or had hoped was a broken shin pad because of the noise, quickly learned it wasn't quite. I think the thing that worried me the most was that I knew my family was watching. It was almost instant once I realised what had happened that it's going to be months, you know, maybe not even a return. But I've had injuries in the past and I've always known that I can come back from them. But to know that my family was watching and would have seen something of this magnitude and the empathy they would have felt for me made me feel really bad. It was really tough, but I was super grateful for all the outreach I've had from fans, from supporters of the club, from everyone at the club, and it's really, really helped me overcome what could easily have been a very hard physical but also psychological hurdle as well.
Alex Fisher suffers a double leg break, both in the tibia and fibula. The game kicks back off against Southend. Corner to Yeovil, which meets Josh Staunton, but a good save from the goalkeeper. Andrew Olawabori makes a darting run into the box past multiple Southend defenders that couldn't find his feet for the cross, and the ball is played out for a corner. The ball is crossed in and met by Bournemouth loanee Owen Bevan, whose header glances over the crossbar. Staunton's half volley is blazed over. Miguel Freckleton brings down Callum Powell, who is on the attack. A free kick to Southend. Another yellow for Miguel, who is sent off for Yeovil. The free kick is cleared, but Yeovil are down to 10 men. Shot bounces off the crossbar and back onto him as he volleys it in to make it 2-0 for the Blues in the 91st minute. Another 3 points dropped for Yeovil and only 7 games left. Fight for their place next year in the National League.
Difference between the teams. Ball comes in our box twice, they score. You should come catch the last one. You're the fucking goalie. Come catch it. I've seen it back. Just come catch the fucking ball. I've said a word. Just come catch the fucking ball. We need your help sometimes. That's fuck all to do in the second half. Come catch the ball, we're still in it. Those in our box twice, they score. How many times more than ever?
And that's the story of your season.
Effort and desire, unbelievable. Quality, zero. That's what you're going to get with the games. It's got no quality. So we've got nearly 40 games now. Scored fucking about 12 goals. Like I say, can't fault your effort, desire, throw your bollocks off. Unfortunately, that ain't enough. Stay in the game, first goal, soft as shit. They've not won, they've lost 7 games. You give them something to hang on to. It's fucking wishy-washy.
Nothing. What can you say? It's a fucking... Worse than put the fucking ball in the back of the net, do they? So it's fucking pointless, you're saying.
You can see the 2 shit goals as well. Yeah? 2 shy goals.
Yeovil stay at 21st with 38 points from 39 games. Fast forward 3 days and 350 miles later to a trip to Gateshead, who are one place above Yeovil and are also in the fight for relegation. 1-0 Gateshead. Two nil, Gateshead. 3-0. Gateshead. Yeovil are broken away from home and lose 4-0 to Gateshead, who move 5 points clear of relegation, but Yeovil stay at 21st. A much needed 3 points at Aldershot can maybe keep Yeovil's survival hopes alive.
To a few of you. When you were, what age did you start playing football?
7.
Why did you play football?
I love it.
You love it. So we need to get back to loving it. You know, if we talk about we have to win today, otherwise, we're going to get the club. Fuck all that shit. I just want you to go and enjoy yourselves. Don't worry about the result. Winning, losing. If we play well, and play well, and play well, what happens?
Win.
You start to win. So I want you to go and play like you were 7 years fucking old. In the playground with your mate. No pressure. Because there is no pressure. No pressure. So I want your chests out, shoulders back. Don't care about the result. Don't care about the result, I'm going to play well. And if we get 7 or 8 today, fucking win. If we'd already been relegated, we wouldn't play today, what now?
Play 3.
Oh, fucking. Of course, near the fucking goal. Gotta be careful, we got to work hard, not all of that. That never changes, whether you're playing World Cup in the back garden with your mates. Still got to defend the goal, otherwise what? You fucking up. But I want you to play with a smile on your face, all of you. Use your ability. Use your ability. Fuck the league, walk down. Get up and down the line, cross it. Most of all, I don't care about the result. I don't care. Honestly, I do not care. I just want a performance where you really look as you want to play. Right?
Yeah.
Come on, boys, let's go. Let's fucking go, eh? You stick together out here. All of us are up. Big fucking shit. Come on.
The link you have and click on BBC Somerset.
Kickoff at Aldershot and a great start from Yeovil. Jordan Young's half volley is just short of the goal.
Charlie Cooper. Yeovil having a good spell of possession. Ball through the middle. Worthington jumps, tries to get contact on it. Just took his eye off the ball. Meanwhile, he's out of position and Worthington's coming down the right-hand side for Yeovil. Taking on Corden, a one-on-one. Shot comes in, it's blocked and it breaks loose to Ashley Hammond.
Keep being positive. Hey, fucking well done. Look a decent team today. Only thing missing. Last bit. Here, where the money? Where you earn your money? Around here. You know what it is? A little bit of lack of belief. It's like, oh, it's good. Fuck that. Just get in there, yeah? Like when you used to play for the under-15s. Get in, fucking shoot, score. This one, concentrate, yeah? When we're playing, always switched on, ready. If it turns over, I'm there. So we don't have to get another yellow card. Two midfield players. Stay on your feet, can't make a foul. Somebody go and get a goal. Somebody go and make a difference. You score first, you win, all right? I've enjoyed watching it. Be good, mature, men, quality. Just like last bit.
Come on, boys, come on. Let's go first!
Here we go,
Yeovil believe in themselves and believe in 3 points.
If that's not a beaten man and a beaten team, I don't know.
Corner starts off the second half, but it is met by Tyler Cordner in the 50th minute. Yeovil are 1-0 down in a much needed win game.
He's got the goal! Tyler Cordner! Aldershot Town 1, Yeovil 0. Headed away again by Yeovil. Maguire Drew lifts a ball over the top.
Jordan Maguire Drew places a long ball to Malachi Linton, who places in Matthew Worthington, who finds Callum Harriott 1-1. Linton gets close.
He finds Hutchinson. Can Aldershot counter? 3 against 4. He's clear ball over the top here.
Aldershot go 1-on-1 in the 85th minute.
Is it a penalty? Yes!
Jory Johnson brings the Aldershot player down in the box, and Aldershot receives a penalty.
Could be a season-defining moment, this.
It could be. Jake Hutchinson against Grant Smith. Hutchinson steps up.
Over the bar. Stays level.
Jake Hutchinson has missed the target from 12 yards.
A little bit more for the corner. Top corner. Cross comes in from Yeovil. There's a clumsy challenge. Nothing given, though. And as a stalemate.
The final whistle is blown. Yeovil managed to grab a point.
Frustration for fuck's sake! Fuck me, man.
Fucking embarrassing.
Fuck!
Personally, I've been working so hard, trying to get in the team. I'm finding myself out the team, in the team, picking up a goal here or there. It's just a mess from top to bottom, really, with what was going on elsewhere. Just coming away from that game, I was real frustrated because that was the one that I thought we have so much quality and we've let ourselves down, fans down, everyone down, and that's when it really sort of started to sink in that we may not stay afloat. So it's good to let emotions out sometimes. It did get the better of me. I wouldn't say I'm the most vocal person after the games because I like to think about things and digest, but from then on I think that sapped a lot of belief out of the boys, and from there it was one less game that we had to win, four games or whatever it was. And what frustrated me is I thought that we could have done it, and I don't know if people wanted it as much as I did, or, you know, hurt me that day, really hurt me that day.
After the point against Aldershot, Yeovil moved down to 22nd, and now 5 points off survival. Yeovil move onto a home fixture against Dorking, who are currently in the battle for survival as they roam on the relegation line. Ready to conquer and ready to get the 3 points for the Glovers. Alex Fisher makes a return to Huish Park to watch the game and to say a few words to the fans after his injury.
Just a very quick one for me. I've been truly humbled by the love and support since the injury last week. And I really can't tell you how much it's helped me get through this last week. And just to be here today was a massive motivation for me to go to help cheer on the guys. It was going to be a really, really big game. And I urge everyone to do the same. We achieved by unity. Thank you so much.
Hey, we'll fucking enjoy it when we come in here. We fucking score a few goals today, won't we? Come on, boy, fucking relentless, come on. I mean, I'm telling you, that was a fucking leggy. Boy, there's fucking a handful of games left, eh? Fucking hell, season defining games, there's fucking unit done, eh? Come on. This one today, mark in the box, Liverpool, Arsenal yesterday, best players in the world, Van Dijk. What are you doing? Fucking mark the man, hold, ball goes wide, one look at the man, at the ball, mark him out, without giving the penalty away. Don't mean you have to be a centre-half, might be a midfield player, might be a wing back, might be a forward who's tracked back. This is what I told you to do the other day. Yeah? You look to me like you did it. You know, like all the shit that goes on around the football club, and you get it at all football clubs. You can't control any of that. I can't control it. These can't control it. That out there, the green bit with the lines on it, and the two goals at each end, is where you can go and switch off from everything. And go and whatever frustration you've got going on in your life, you can go and take it out there and forget about everything for 90 minutes. And that's what we need to do, that's what we're about. So if you're a forward, fucking run after the ball. Midfield players, positionally perfect. Play, set, spin, tackle, head, all of that. Wing backs, up and down, cross, score, defend. Centre halves, defend the box, play forward quality. Goalkeeper, aggressive, come and catch the ball. Boys, you've got nothing to worry about. Trust me, nothing to worry about. I just want you to go. I ask you for performances. Can't guarantee results. You can't guarantee a result. If you get another performance and it's a little bit better, you win. Yeah?
you win. Then we see what happens after that.
A massive 90 minutes for Yeovil. Matty Worthington wins the ball for Scott Pollock and the ball goes out for a corner. Cleared away by Dorking. Chory Johnson goes in with a harsh tackle on the edge of the box. Chory only receives a yellow card and will have to be careful. Another nasty challenge, but on Owen Bevan this time. The ball is crossed in, but unfortunately, the header drifts wide. Offside for Yeovil, but Mark Cooper is not happy with the decision. A few words are shared by the referee, and Mark Cooper is shown a yellow card. Good defending by Josh Thornton. Another foul from Chory Johnson. The referee hands out another yellow to Chory, and he is sent off. Yeovil are down to 10 men with 45 minutes to play. Just a minute after Chory is sent off, the game hits half-time. Players aren't happy as they thought they had a chance on goal, but the referee blows for half-time.
Boys, what do you think to that?
Crap, I
don't know. One man difference ain't gonna make. Ain't gonna make a difference to us. We can hide the gap so we can shuffle across. Well, it says, in the middle of the pitch, fucking be solid in the middle, be strong in the middle of the pitch. Yeah? If you're making a tackle, make sure that the ball and the man together doesn't go past you. You've been booked, be careful then. Be careful. So, we need to know who's been booked for them. When we target somebody, and we try and get one of them sent off. Andrew, in possession, free up front. Yeah, you on the right, out of possession, get yourself back in level with Coops and Worthy. You've got work, it's going to be 45 minutes to graft. Run your bollocks off, up and down, take people on, shoot, cross. Yeah, hey, what a brilliant achievement. How good would we feel at the end of these fucking world? If we have to take a point, we're going to try and win.
Well, he set these in a massive now, so I'll get a fucking chance to get these.
Stewie's right, anticipation's got the bounce. Did somebody get onto it and fucking shoot?
Come on, Wesley.
A
big 45 minutes for Yeovil. Yeovil start the half with Miguel Freckleton making a run down the line, but unfortunately, his shot is deflected wide. Malachi Linton with another chance for Yeovil.
Come on,
But in the 74th minute, Jason Pryor scores for Dorking. A good save from Grant Smith, but unfortunately, it's not enough, and Yeovil lose vital 3 points.
How shit are we in my wind, crap? We're fucking winning. It's always up front. I know you said the flat, but you have no pressure. If we get the ball away, they fucking score. You get the ball away, nothing happens. So I don't understand why everyone's fucking scared of it. Because it's a fucking free hit. Every week, you can't do anything wrong. We make one mistake at the back, we lose 1-0. We don't do a fucking thing. Like, there's nothing to be, like that in the pitch, there's nothing to be scared of. Literally nothing. If you give it away, they've got to run like 90 yards. If you score 38 goals in the season, you deserve to go down. Simple as that. Bit of fucking pride. Fucking heartbroken.
I don't think we realise how damaging this is for your career's got.
No, exactly. Some of us have never come out from this. You'll get lost in the lower leagues forever. We've let your manager down. We've let your club down.
Auction Palace, one thing we've let each other down. Really have. All the season we've let each other down.
Boys, can't fight the refa. Work your fucking bollocks off. Yeah, the referee's shit. All of that. Same problem. Top of the pitch. It doesn't just mean faults when we're around the box. We never look like we're going to score a goal. Unless it's a fucking mistake, somebody falls over, or we get a deflection.
No time. It's not the time for recriminations. It's not the time for nailing people. We know what's coming, we have to accept it and get on with it. See what the clowns do going forward.
No, I'm not being a footballer, but he's a good one. You've got to graft, you've got to train, you've got to be on top all the time. You've got a real desire to be. It's alright, it's easy to be an average one, play now and again, to be a really good one, and to win promotion, to win cups, to be right at it. We've got 4 or 5 with every week that are at it. Can't only have 4 or 5.
Yeovil move further away from survival and stay at 22nd, falling 6 points deep into the relegation zone. Yeovil travel to Solihull Moor, where we grab a point but move 8 points deep into relegation. 18th of April, 2023. Wrexham versus Yeovil.
Searching every corner of my mind.
Yeovil have to win against Wrexham to have any chance of staying up. But if they lose today, Yeovil are relegated.
I have my reasons and life has its lessons. I try to be grateful and count all my blessings. But heavy is the head that
wears. Wrexham sit top of the National League, and they look to seal 3 points to inch closer to the title. The Racecourse, Wales, owned by Hollywood superstars Ryan Reynolds and Rob McElhenney. Will Buse, who started against Wrexham, in just his second appearance this season.
So I found out I was playing, we got to the ground, we walked into the change room, my name was on the board. I was obviously excited, walked through the tunnel onto the pitch. I thought this is a proper game. Come out to the warm-up, there's a buzz about it, there's excitement. Obviously, on a personal note, I was really excited to start and to play the game, but as a team, we know we had a big task ahead of us.
The stage is set. The battle of survival for Yeovil or victory for Wrexham. 10,000 people sit in attendance for the game.
I have my life has its lessons. Try to be grateful and count all my blessings. But heavy is the head that wears the crown.
Scott Pollock kicks the game off. Rio Griffiths runs past the Wrexham defenders and it's out for a corner. The ball is crossed in by Charlie Cooper and met by Miguel Freckleton, whose flick is deflected just wide of the post. Another corner, similar to the last, sees the ball safely in Ben Foster's gloves. Josh Staunton holds Ben Foster to stop him playing quickly. Wrexham have their first chance. Paul Mullen places the ball to Andy Cannon, whose shot is wide but a close effort. Elliot Lee places the ball forward to Anthony Ford, who is taken down by Owen Bevan. A foul on Bevs. Yet again, Owen Bevan finds himself one-on-one with the Wrexham man, but again is taken down. Bev goes down and looks to hold his thigh in the process. Owen Bevan is brought off. This could be a big loss for Yeovil. A comfortable save from Will Buse after a weak shot from Mullen. Worthy finds himself in on goal and tests Ben Foster, but a comfortable save for the experienced goalkeeper. Wrexham play quick. And Elliot Lee tries to find a cross into the box, but Freckleton is there to clear away. A foul by Freckleton. And a yellow card. The free kick is cleared away for a corner, which is also cleared. An attack breaks for Yeovil, but nothing comes from it as Wrexham break again. But the shot is over the bar. A great 45 minutes from Yeovil.
Right, boys, give me 2 minutes. You've done good, yeah?
Yeah.
You've done good, calm. Taking the energy out of the stadium, yeah? Half the job done. Can't give them any energy, do you know what I mean by that?
Don't let them
counter-attack, give sillies or fouls, let them put it in the box. Don't let them get ahead of steam on. Be able to take the sting out of the game. Different ways to do that.
By a free kick.
What else? What else?
Keep the ball.
Fucking keep the ball. Keep the ball. Once we work our way into the last third, we've done it really well. So we've got from the edge of our box to in and around there. It's good, yeah? Don't be in too much of a rush to get down the sides and smash it across the goal. They've got three centre half. Sometimes it might be you, Andrew. Hook out and go back. Yeah? Or it might be Rick. Don't be in a rush. Come out, play. They're weak. If that's the box and we get here, they're really strong along here. Line. Big fucking monsters. They're strong. They're weak. Here. Really weak. All run towards the goal. They don't cover that. So once we get in these areas here, it might be you get here and it's that, or you turn out or we go there, then across for a shot. Get that? Stay calm with the ball. We can play more. We can play more. You know, outside they crow, oh, we stop booting it. Turn out that pass. Play. Give the front boys a rest so they can get a position and then we can play through. I've enjoyed it. I haven't felt under pressure or bothered about it. They haven't really hurt us, have they? At all.
The longer the game goes on, the more frustrated the fans start to get.
they'll start being panicky, that it'll build tension where we can then catch them because they'll gamble. So you're going to be prepared for that. They'll have overloads and stuff, they'll be bombing forward trying to get the goal. But on the flip side of that, we can turn all the play and go and hurt them.
A massive opportunity, come on.
One of the biggest 45 minutes to go for all of these players. Yeovil need to score. A good strike, but deflected away for a Wrexham corner. Ball is lost and Wrexham are on the attack. Deflected and in. Wrexham take the lead. Yeovil do not give up and go again with Andrew Oluwabori, but a foul is blown by the referee. Wrexham yet again go on the attack, but the ball is deflected over the bar. A cross comes in and it is a scramble in the box as Yeovil look to clear. But James Jones is there to tap it in for Wrexham. They lead 2-0. Yeovil know that a 2-0 lead at Wrexham is usually game, set and match, but they try to hang on with the thought of survival. A good save by Will Buse. Yeovil try and look for more, but they see Wrexham on the attack again. But fortunately, the shot is over by Elliot Lee. Another cross into Yeovil's box. Wrexham lead 3-0 with a Paul Mullins header. Yeovil know what is coming at the end, and they know survival hopes are fading quickly. Jordan Young tries his luck, but save. Yeovil are relegated.
And that is the full-time whistle, which means Yeovil Town, just 10 years after playing in the second tier of English football, this defeat at Wrexham confirms it, but just 7 wins in 44 league games condemns the Glovers to a fourth relegation in just 9 years.
Celebrations ring out from the racecourse, but cries scream out from Somerset.
Boys, where was the game lost?
Right.
So what did you do in the last 10 minutes of the game? Right, so what's the difference between the first 10 minutes?
We let them.
What did I say at half time? Don't come off. We kept getting it. no danger, kicking the fucking ball out of play. Or kicking it straight to them. Last 10 minutes, we turn out, make a run, they can't get the ball. Yeah, 3-0 up. 3-0, for the sake, have the ball. Oh, you take that energy, you've got to turn out and play. Kicking it out of play, kicking it straight to the defender. It was fucking horrendous for the goals. By the way, horrendous. People falling over, nobody marking at the back post. From here to here, we're like mid-table team. Here, whole team, that's why we're bottom of the league. Oh, relegated. Final third. Let's go as quick as you can to get out of here.
After the defeat and being relegated, Yeovil moved 9 points deep into relegation.
Josh, it's hard to know where to start. That is relegation confirmed. You must be heartbroken.
Yeah, I'm devastated, to be honest. Not for myself, for the people of the football club. This is a special club. This football club isn't about me. It's not about the gaffer. It's not about whoever's at the top. It's about the people, the good people at the football club. It's about the Pat Custards. It's about the Shelleys. It's about people like yourself, Jack and Henry, the young lads who wait there every week. Do you know what I mean? It's about them. This club will rise again because good people, good things happen to good people in the long run. We'll be back. We just need to do it right.
Yeovil go on to their last game in the National League against Oldham Athletic.
Harley Cooper.
Certainly is, isn't he? Kitchen cutting inside, beats Worthington, cross going to come in towards the back post and in.
8 minutes in, Yeovil go 1-0 down to a volley from Devon Green.
Devon Green gets the goal on 8 minutes.
Yeovil look defeated. Half time comes quickly. Miguel Freckleton confronts the boys in the dressing room.
Maybe he needs to go long, it's got a fucking stick. We can't keep fucking stitching people up, because when he has to go long, we've looked like no one wants to. Sometimes we have to turn a shit ball into a good ball for someone. Do you know what I mean? Because it's fucking easy. He's a 19-year-old boy, fucking target.
A push and a shove from Chris Todd starts the second half. In the 74th minute, Oldham make it 2. Defeated Yeovil, go again. Free kick to Oldham.
It's Fondorp and it's in.
3-0 to Oldham.
Second of the afternoon.
A disappointing end to the last game at home for such a struggling season for everyone around Yeovil. The Glovers go on to lose 1-0 in their last game away to Boreham Wood. Yeovil looked deflated and seemed to just look forward to next season. The stewardships of Matt Ugler and Paul Sackey falls through as Yeovil drop into the National League South. As Yeovil are close to falling into administration, a local businessman, Martin Hellier, plans his offer for Yeovil and purchases his boyhood club.
Yeovil Town fans, we are now embarking on a truly locally owned, locally loved club. All the bad times are gone. We've got the budget, players, the staff have a sense of purpose, the fans have a sense of pride, and we can now collectively move forward with all the bad things gone, achieving by unity. Let's forget all about the bad stuff. We all saw all of that. Now let's look forward to all the good stuff that's going to come. With me as your local owner, listening to everything you've got to say and hoping to move forward, get out of this little season we're in now and move it up. All the resources are there. Bring the soul back to the club and shout and cheer and look forward to proper football where all we talk about is the football on the pitch and none of the rubbish outside of it. Wishing you all really good luck. Thank you for your patience, your support, and let's see how we get on.
Come on, you Glovers.